Now here you see, this is phylum Arthropoda, and it is supposed to be the largest phylum. Okay, the largest phylum of Animalia that includes 2/3 of all the named species on earth and are arthropods, and they have got, see what are the specification is, the organ system level of organization, the body is bilaterally symmetrical, okay, the body is bilaterally symmetrical, then triploblastic and coelomate. So these are the four phylum characters you have. Then body of an arthropod is covered by a chitinous layer of exoskeleton, body divided into head, thorax and abdomen, the jointed appendages. See all the insects and worms, you find it here, rather insects. Okay, now you see respiratory organ. What are the respiratory organs? Gills, book gills for aquatic arthropod, book lungs or tracheal system. The circulatory system is open system. That means what? The mixing of the venous and oxidated and non-oxidated blood is there. That is known as open system. Sensory organs, antenna they have got, eyes they have got a pair of compound and simple eyes. Then statocytes. What are statocytes? They are balancing organs are present, and excretion. See, this is also an identifying thing, that is the Malpighian tibule. The Malpighian tibule is present and they are mostly dioecious. That means sexes are separate. Fertilization is usually internal. See the advanced character, it is not an external, so it is an internal fertilization. Example, what are the examples? Apis, that is honeybee, Bombyx muri, the silkworm, the lucifer, the lark insects. Now vectors, what are vectors? Now vectors are, they are animals that transmit diseases through another animal. For example, the Anopheles mosquito. Female Anopheles mosquito is a vector of malaria, Plasmodium vivax. So the virus, this vector collects the protozoa from one host and transmit it to the another host. And you know, the certain part of the life cycle is going on inside the female Anopheles mosquito, Culex mosquito, Aedes mosquito. These are there. Now another, they are pest. You know, pest, that means they destroy the crops, that is locust. And they are living fossil, that is Limunus, that is known as a king crab. Now another one, the next phylum is the phylum Mollusca, and it is supposed to be the second largest. Now the phylum character here you find is the presence of a shell. The presence of a shell, the organs are especially marine and freshwater, they are all either they are marine or they are amphibious in nature. The body is bilaterally symmetrical, triploblastic, coelomate, and body is covered with a calcareous shell. See, snail is an example. Now head and the muscular foot and the visceral hum is always visible, and later you cannot see. A soft and a spongy layer of skin forms the mantle over the visceral hum, and the space between the hum and the hump and the mantle is called the mantle cavity inside, in which feather-like gills are there, the respiratory organs are there, the external functions, the anterior head. And ultimately, you see, they have got a file-like rasping organ for feeding, and that is known as the radulus. Okay, radulus, that means the mouth part. They have got a very well-developed mouth part. Okay. Now you see, after that, radulus, see they are dioecious. What is dioecious? That means the sexes are separate. Oviparous, that means they lay egg with indirect development. Example, pila, that is apple snail. Okay, sepia, and even that sepia, loligo, squids, octopus, we all have it in this phylum. Then comes the phylum Echinodermata. Now this Echinodermata is supposed to be the phylum. They are all extremely marine. The body is radially symmetrical, and then radially and bilaterally symmetrical. But the thing is, they have got endoskeleton. Endoskeleton means they have got calcareous shell that is found within the body structure of the organism. The body is bilaterally symmetrical. The digestive system is complete with mouth on the lower ventral side and anus on the dorsal side. So two type. And the another identifying character of this phylum is they have got a water vascular system. So water vascular system is a locomotory organ, and they have got a fluid filled tube system structure that is helps the organ in moving from one to other. Now, sexes are separate. That means they are dioecious in nature. Reproduction is sexual and fertilization is usually external. See, this is another thing. Larval stages are there. Example, starfishes. Starfishes, sand dollar, sea cucumber, sea urchins, these are all thing. Now, the next one is known as the hemichordates. What is hemichordate? Hemichordate is linking the echinodermata to the phylum chordata. So obviously they have got certain rudimentary developing vertebral column. So that is why it is known as the hemichordata. Okay, now what is there? They have got somatocords, a structure similar to notochord. Now, always they are worm-like organisms, bilateral symmetrical body. The body is divided into, and then generally they are filter feeders. Filter feeder means they have got a very sedentary lifestyle. They are always stuck to the mud. They filter the water and have the food. They have got a proboscis, the collar-like structure. And they have got a long trunk. They are all worm-like. Example, balanoglossus is an example. Okay, now fertilization is external. Excretory organ is a proboscis gland. Okay, now development is indirect. That means they don't lay eggs. And then the phylum chordata, that would be done in the next class.